Hey guys, I'm back with another battle, and this time I am facing someone that I'm sure you all know, the 205. This was a really fun battle, so be prepared for a really cool battle, I guess. And whenever it's a battle that I think is like super important, I put it in Stargazer Coliseum or whatever it's called. So, yeah, I thought this would be an epic battle, and it was. Alright, so I start off with my Weavile like normal, and he starts with a Smeargle. So I'll just hit him with a Brick Break, because that's super effective. And this should kill him. But he has a stupid Focus Sash. And then he just comes out with Spore. I had a feeling he had that. Now, I would normally, if I was playing with Sleep Claws, I would have switched, but I wasn't really sure if we were or not. He asked me if we were playing with Sleep Claws. I said, I don't care. He just said, okay. So I'm not sure if we were playing with it or not. So I just didn't want to take a chance. So I'm just going to pray that Weavile wakes up. So I don't know. He sends out his Meganium. If I wake up, I'm good, because ice is good against grass. And then he uses Reflect. So, I know his plan. He's putting me to sleep so he has time to raise his defenses and stuff. And then a light screen also. So, now if I wake up, I'm pretty much screwed because I can't hurt him at all. But that's why I'm going to use Brick Break rather than Ice Punch, because I'll get rid of the barriers. Now, I'm not sure if Brick Break breaks both of the barriers or just one. Do you guys know that by any chance? If the opponent used both Reflect and Light Screen and used Brick Break, does it break both or just one? I'm not sure. But whatever, I used it and it said it broke the barrier, so now I'm just going to take the chance and use an Ice Punch next. Anytime now, I'm going to use an Ice Punch. Yep, there we go. And his Meganium seems to have some pretty good defense, and it doesn't kill it. That's why I have a feeling Brick Break only knocked out the light screen rather than both. But oh well. I do really think it knocked out both, but the only reason I think it knocked down one is because I didn't kill Meganium. Maybe because he just has good defense anyway, but whatever. Now he's going to switch. Now, this I kind of laughed at. Maybe he forgot Smeargle only had 1 HP left, because now I just kill him. All I did was switch Meganium out and sent out Smeargle to die. Oh well. And then he sends out Scizor. And, I'm still not gonna switch. I'm just gonna see if, I don't know. He uses a quick attack, so Vexen's dead. But that's okay. He's the only Pokemon I've used the whole time. So, I think it's going pretty good. I've only lost one guy. So is he. So, never mind. And now, normally you'd think that Tyranitar is a bad choice because Scizor is Steel and Bug, and both of those types are good against Tyranitar. But I bet he didn't know that I have a Fire Attack with Tyranitar. So he uses Swords Dance, not expecting a strong attack. But then I unleash a Fire Fang. I always want to have at least one move of every type there is on my Pokemon at some point, and so I needed fire. I needed a fire attack on somebody, so I gave Fire Fang to Tyranitar. And then he sends out his Azumarill, and I was about to switch, but then I thought, no, there's no way Azumarill can beat Tyranitar in one hit, right? 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 And then he gets a critical hit. But I bet he would not have killed me one hit if it was not a critical hit. Because My Tyranitar has really good defense. And that Sandstorm kills both of us for the rest of the battle. Okay, but now I send out my Electivire. And if you want to know why Electivire doesn't have a nickname, it's because this is the one that I got from Battle Revolution. It's you type in like a code and you get him. He's in code that sounds like hacking, but no, he's a completely legit Pokemon. You just get it. It's kind of like an event in Battle Revolution by typing in a code. But I replaced his Cross Chop with Brick Break because misses so much. But yeah, I beat him. There's that Sandstorm again. So now he sends out his Cacturn. I have a feeling he has like some move that will kill me, but I'm just gonna try my Ice Punch anyway. Yes, I know Ice Punch. And then he comes out with a Sucker Punch. A little tip for you guys, if you ever battle me, Sucker Punch will work 99% of the time because I don't think I have any moves that are non-damaging. So. At least on my main team. Oh, other than Gengar's Destiny Bond, I don't think I do. I don't worry about, like... When I do a battle, I don't want to have to think too much. I just... want to use strong attacks and stuff. So I bet you're thinking, why I use a Starmie, a water type against a grass type? Well, Starmie is my fastest Pokemon, I think. And he knows Ice Beam, which is really strong against a grass type. So that's why I used it. But I would have been screwed if he used Sucker Punch, because that was super effective. So I'm glad he didn't. And now, who does he send out? Oh, is that Clefable or Wigglytuff? Clefable, yeah. I skipped this, I cut this whole part out. This is the whole battle between Starmie and a Clefable. I use a Surf, he heals. Then I use another Surf, he uses Cosmic Power. Then I Surf, he heals again. It's just back and forth between that, and he never uses an actual hurting attack on me. Oh, I forgot about Thunder Wave. Okay, but yeah, now first, he uses Thunder Wave. Now it's just constant, me surfing, then him healing, or using Cosmic Power. So, yeah, I cut out pretty much all of this battle. I think I kept the first part just so you could see what it was exactly. See, just a Cosmic Power. Then a Surf. Which doesn't do much. At all. The Sandstorm is really the only thing that's hurting me, because he doesn't use an actual hurting attack. I'm not sure if he had one or not, but... Nonetheless, he did not use a single one. See, it's just switching off between healing and using Cosmic Power. And now I completely skipped to the end, see? Where I don't have very much HP left.
Mom, the phone's ringing!
And yeah, I get a critical hit. Well, why won't someone answer my phone? I'm not gonna answer my phone when I'm recording. But anyway, yeah, I get lucky with a critical hit there. That's what I was hoping for that whole time. I was not gonna switch out. And now I'm thinking, oh, I'm gonna win, because I'll go first. But I forgot that I was paralyzed. So, I did not go first. And now, at this point, I think I really thought I was going to lose because I forgot I had Gengar left. I thought my only Pokemon left was Swampert, and he can't stand a chance against the grass type. It's 4 times super effective against him. So I send out Gengar, and he finishes off this battle just like my last battle, but in a different way. Finishes off the last battle with the Destiny Bond. He finishes this battle off the old-fashioned way, just by killing. And that is our battle against the 205. That was a really fun battle. Not that Renabelle's wasn't fun, but this one was like, wow. I really thought I was gonna lose. But yeah, awesome battle, dude. And I'll do more battles, I guess, some other time with other people and stuff. So I don't know. See y'all later, and rock on.